And after the first two games, with the first game total domination, the second one was closer, but the slam was super strong. We're going to see now the third, and hopefully the third is going to be now the starting to the comeback from Fiona and Melkor, because we want to see more games go. More looties, and we are in the game right now, and we have, oh man, Mirror Civilizations, Huns and Mongols. Huns and Mongols, they went Mirror Civs and Huns and Mongols. Beautiful, man, to be honest, beautiful. But with Huns and Mongols, I will say something fast and unpredictable. The advantage might be better, might be bigger for Islam and Barry. Well, it's possible. Well, let's see, guys. Let's see. Huns and Mongols. The comeback is real. Let's see, man. Let's see. We have Blue Slam Boy with Mongols facing Melkor Huns. So Huns versus Mongols in both matchups. Well, of course, you know, like you can see, Mongols facing Barry with the Huns. Well, Huns know how to play. But you know how to play Huns, right? Well, you can change your bettings, Alepa Leon. You can change your bettings and you can make another betting if you don't feel, and it will keep the other one the same. See top 49. My god. Option 1. See top 49. Is Mirror, yes. The third game in loser bracket is not Huns. It's not Huns, it's absolutely Mirror Civilizations. Yeah. Hidden pick is the game five. Okay. Well, let's see what are they going to do. This is desert like Arabia. The maps are bad. So let's see. Yeah, you did in the last second. No, the stream is perfect. According to the OBS, the stream is perfect. Is heavy settings. You need some good connection to watch the stream on source, because I am streaming full HD, 60 frames per second, and I am uploading with really, really strong bitrate. You can check the statistics of the image video and you will see what I'm talking about. Hopefully it's working good for everyone. Hello from Hong Kong, Balawila. Well, welcome to the channel, and this time is good for people in Asia. Nice. I guess that, except in China, in all the other countries, Twitch is working good, or you have to set up also VPN as well. No, Colmongo, you should know this already. Oh my god, Nubio, this is for the winner brackets, not for the loser bracket. I have said already, but since you have me muted, I'm going to kill you, man. I have explained already. Anyway, now Huns and Mongols, and with map really open. He has three villages. He's going to take that deer. Ay ay ay. Slam Boy, that wasn't the best luring, right? Let's see how fast Slam is going to go. And four villages on wood. Is he gonna go for the trash? Well, he's pushing the deers, and Fëanor is going to do what? Let me check from Timotheus. Fëanor, how many villages on wood? Four villages. So okay, let's see. Not many. I didn't sleep too much. I wake up for this game, so 3-4 hours, no more. And I fell asleep with my wife in the sofa. We were, yeah. Actually, she came this morning and said, Danny, didn't you have a stream this morning? And I said, oh, what time is it? She told me, 8:40. And I said, it's in 20 minutes, let me sleep 5 minutes more. And she was like, I don't care, you do what you want. Okay, deer's coming to the town center, and Matthews and Timotheus also on the way with 21, and Islam is the fastest with 20 population. 20 population. Alright. Okay. Two villagers doing the barrack on top of that hill. Those crazy hills are terrible, terrible to protect. And all the goals are forward. Look, 1, 2, 3. Melkor should go aggressive. Really aggressive. But how to play aggressive against Islam? They really need a strong teamwork here. Definitely. But these civilizations with against the tyrants are just tricky. They are super fast. Look at now Barry doing the little palisade and the barrack as well. So Dolly Dax, Loom. Little palisade. And I expect it is stable. Maybe soon, if the game go longer, we will see some tower located here, because the map is awful for Islam. The map is really awful. He has no wood at all. Look, only this one. Other than that, it's a terrible map. Terrible map, really. They should try to go, yeah, both is stable. They should try to go double, definitely. Double to Islam with that map. But then Barry is doing a stable as well. Everyone with a stable, great scouts. Let's see who is gonna have, yeah, better teamwork. It's what is gonna matter here for sure. Oh, with all the scouts, teamwork is crucial. Easy palisade there, and I will make some little palisade here as well, maybe. I don't know. He's so exposed. We're gonna make another lambrecam. Yeah. Let's see if Melkor can see Slam. He cannot, man. He just cannot. So now with the scouts, okay. But he's not going. Thank you for the loots. Thank you for the loots. Go, 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 guys. Yeah. This is the rating. If you want to see crystal clear, like the quality it is in 60 frames per second. Yeah. Those are the crazy settings that I'm doing, and hopefully it's working good for everyone. Thank you for the following. Welcome to the channel, Troy AOC. And be careful, man, be careful. All right good morning, Cambre. Yes, 2-0, man. 2-0, fast and unpredictable, definitely. Oh, and Valia down. He's down. Just go bottom. Otherwise, he's not gonna be able to wall. Yeah, but why he want to palisade there when this is super open? I don't get it. I really don't get it. Well, he's full of scouts, but he's doing the tower exactly in the spot I was suggesting some time ago. 6 scouts now. Okay, and he's sending 2 villages. But dude, I don't get it. Now archer range, okay. It doesn't matter anymore, see top 49, because it's, the pettings are close. Well, Barry, look at Barry walls. Oh man, so ugly walls, but he's walling everything. Everything. And the power of the Huns doing some scouts. Palisade. Yeah, they're walling everything. Everyone. Scout to you. Made no problem. Has the tower, so he's protected. At the back, he has little palisade on that wood. And little palisade as well, so he's well protected. Definitely. Tone Watch will borrow now for Timotheus, for Melkor. Let's go to Islam point of view. I love this upgrade. Yeah, look at the Tone Watch. He can watch everything. Now go back. He has a lot of scouts. Lot of scouts. 10 army, 9 army from Melkor, but Melkor is doing the archer range, right? Double archer range, actually. So go aggressive. He saved all the scouts, but his 2 archer ranges. That's really all doing the wheelbarrow at the same time, almost. With 30 second difference only. Okay, Fëanor is doing a good job. Fëanor is definitely doing a good job there. Alright. Doing the damage on a slam. But Barry is about to click up. Yeah, man. He's with the resources. Strong resources. Ah, but check, guys. Look. Has 3 scouts. 2 are almost dead. You have to check. Remember, when you are playing and against a scout rush, you really need to pay attention to that. It's really important. With 3 villages, he could have killed all those scouts. Some little micro, and that's it. Now he's sending more scouts, and he should send the archers now. Fast and unpredictable. Barry's about to click up, slam, gathering good resources. Melkor, good resources as well. But he has the advantage. He has 2 archer ranges. Take the advantage for those archer ranges, because... but this is terrible, guys. He don't know yet where the wood it is. So if you don't explore, you have nothing, absolutely nothing to do. Barry is on the way to Castle Edge, 20 minutes, 20 seconds. So walling like he's walling, he's going up super fast. He managed the economy, the macro economy, really well. And he's going up. And now Melkor is going with more scouts, but he still don't see anything. Timotheus is still not going up. Will go soon, but gonna be big problems. I assume. Big problems, I'm telling you. Slam going to go up. Slam is clicking up too. The advantage is huge. This is looking really, really closer to the 3-0, but the thing is, Slam and Barry, both players are, guys, 2.4k. 2.4k, that's it. A little Pisaid put 2 spears. Now Melkor is about, and he's clicking up. It's 50 seconds difference only, which is okay. Even more when he's 38 villagers. Timotheus now is on the way to Castle Edge. Okay, that's cool too. But he's gonna be 2 minutes behind. In two minutes, Barry with archers. Transition future crossbows. He's not walled completely. He has problems. And he's already inside. Oh my god. How he's already inside. He's in castle. Now he's doing a tower. And he's gonna lose that villager. He's saving the villager in the last second. That's good. Now mining a stone. But he needs another tower fast. And also was open on the left. Oh man, don't send the villager like this. A sloppy boy. Sloppy boy. Yeah, losing another villager. He shouldn't lose it. But he lost it. Lot of archers. Well, Islam is going what? Knights. Okay. Is he going to help him? Yeah, he's going to his brother. Timotheus Potlanes and a scale bard in armor. With how many stables? 1 stable. Okay, Islam doing the chain bard in armor. He did 2 houses. Really good house. Really good building there. Is with Bodkin, and losing another villager. There you go, man. Don't lose 2 villages like this. Come on. Now doing the tower. 42 population. Slam 42 as well. Yeah, but Fëanor is losing villages, man. Okay. Okay, let's see. Well, Vivian team, for example, too. There are some few players that they can't do it. They really can't do it. They still have some players that didn't join this tournament, but according to the people that joined, and this is a really good tempo. Really good that red is there. Really, really good that red is there with a lot of crossbows. Yeah, that was really nice. Otherwise, yellow will be in a really, really bad position. He's sending the knights and the scouts, but he's killing those crossbows. Definitely. And the wolves are doing the damage. Okay. Nah, he killed all the archers, man. This is a great job, man. Melkor did a great job. Let's raid. Let's raid. Alright, he's gonna raid. He's not doing another stable. But really, he should go and do the damage there. Well, 75 population. Melkor, 75 population. Yellow is the one who is in problems. Wall, man. Wall. Wall. Supi and the Max. Yes. Good. Good. Good team as well. Definitely. There is a lot of people. Strong. Ay, ay, ay. Be careful. DC on the goal. Be careful, man. Be careful. He's raiding. Thank you for the following. Look at those knights. Now he's killing those scouts with so many knights. And those camels. Be careful, man. Alright. 46 population. Timoteus. Ay, ay, ay. Mr. Yo is not playing this tournament. Mr. Yo is basically not playing AOC lately. But now he's fine. He's gonna kill all the knights there. Okay. Well, let's see. Timoteus is the one who is really behind. Really, really behind. Oh my god. And he's still not walling. Why he's not walling that spot? Can you tell me why he's not walling? Why he's still not rewalling? Yeah. Yellow is basically bye-bye. With the cav arches, let's see if he can do the damage. He can do some damage. Definitely he has to... the Thumbrin and everything, but I don't know. Okay. Go back with those. Well, he has bloodlines, Thumbrin. He should put in. Let's see. Oh, there is a lot of crossbows now doing the damage. There you go. But how to stop now, Barry? 46 population. Sadly, this is gonna be serious. Really fast serious, definitely. Super fast serious. Ay, ay, ay. Thank you for the following. Oh man, now he's gonna lose all those. Look at the Mangonel, you need to be careful. Well, he keeps trying to raid. Really strong population for red. He's trying to make the damage and he's doing the damage. Hans is absolutely superior. He's superior in this kind of castle fight. They are crazy with the cav archers. And look at this. He put on a great spot there with the crossbows. He need to be really, really careful. Now he's doing a tower in on that stone, cav archers, archers as well, and 106 population, be careful, stone mining, Doubt is playing, guys. I streamed 2 days ago his game from Master of Arabia, and they will play. The winner of this series that is looking at is going to be Barry and Melkor, but now here those cav archers doing the damage well. 48 villagers, and 68 Melkor. So even with that rating, the village numbers are better for Islam. It's true that he has 45 army. Trying to get inside, he's not walling, but he's constantly raiding also yellow. The good thing is that Islam is moving a bit. 121, 116. Well, both are constantly raiding the Mongols, but you can see that the difference is there, man. Oh, well, slum is going down, man. Slum is going down. Look at the population. Now it's the same. Is the same population than Feanor. Okay. Yeah, but all those players are not playing actually too much. They really don't play. Well, Melkor is with a strong advantage with the Slam. Definitely. Slam 75 values. Melkor 85. But Parry.
Yes.
Parry has 94 values. 94 values. And now Parry is gonna be able to deal probably with all. Well, Melkor has plus 2 and yellow is not going. Yellow, come on, man. Go there. Oh my god, look at this, man. Look at this. Okay. Cartography, Thumbrain, and 147 population. I have no army, yes. Slam got no army. So, but look at Barry, he's getting the heal advantage. And now they can do the damage. They can do finally the damage. There you go. There you go. That's the way to go. But still, they need to attack Barry. 103 villages. 103 villages is still behind. Yellow really, really behind. And Barry, let's go to Barry point of view. Yeah, he will gather the resource. Oh, Melkor is on the way to Imperial. Whoa! Okay, let's see if he can do the damage. He's on the way to Imperial Husbandry. And let's see if he can somehow kill his lamb. I don't know, or pushing the other side, but he's trying to keep raiding more and more to Feanor. Oh man, and he's killing also those villagers. Are you okay? Yeah, he's okay. Definitely he's okay. He keep raiding yellow. With 73 population, Melkor is up, like we said. No resources, Slam is gathering the resources. Oh my god, he doesn't have army, yes. But he's still getting a good boom. He's now doing a castle, so he's gonna be able to go up Imperial soon. But let's see if Red can do something. He's faster than... Okay, Camel is now to defend. Go, go, go. Yeah. But he's still not rewalling, so he's getting raided all the time. How they can be close if they don't play anymore? Loisa, Kreese, Ra, Pinchester play some, but all the others don't play anything. Thank you for the following. Well, Mogo, why Dogawa and Nikov? Nikov and Miguel already did it. Okay, look at the castle. One, two tone centers, a lot of farmers. Barry on the way to Imperial as well. Slam on the way to Imperial. Yeah. But he should attack fast. He should really attack fast. And he is still not rewalling. So he's constantly getting raided. Rewall! What the hell, man? Ay, 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 man. Ay, ay, ay. Okay, this is a pause. This is a pause. I don't want to be disrespectful, but I think you are talking a bit no sense right now because you are watching how they are winning Feanor and Melkor. No offense, but they are. I mean, Melkor is 2k plus, 2k1 maybe, but Feanor is not even 2k. So it's obvious that Slam and Barry are clearly favorite against this. Oh man, but the heavy cav archers, heavy cav archers. Let's see if he can make some raiding. But still, the population is not the best. They should wall a bit and also start to trade, maybe. Well, not needed. He has a castle on top of that hill, which is great. And now, raid, man. Raid before Barry is getting Imperial. There you go. He's there, man. He's there. But then Slam will have the power of the Mago Dice activated, really. 130 population, 100.
Yes.
Hands on me for 10 minutes already. Yeah, it's truth. But the slam was in some problems. Let's see now. He's ready more and more. Heavy cap archers. Well, let's see if like this yellow can recover. Timoteus still far from going up. Far from going up. But the slam, elite Magundais. Abrasor, Playboy TV. Upgrade. Okay, he has now 3 castles, slam. He has to go?
Yes.
Oh my god. He has to go, Barry? For real? Well, hopefully he's not going. I wake up for this game, so don't go anywhere. Go and play. Anyway, played Barden Armor, Cavalier. This is still pretty much 2 versus 1. But Melkor is playing now strong, really strong. 164 population, look his score. Timoteus is still not going up. I don't know if maybe he saw this link. No, he need to recover and be in the game. Definitely. Go, go, go. Okay, let's see. It's gonna be Cavaliers. He has Cavaliers already. This is elite. Magunda is not fully armored, but he's going to make another castle. The Cap Archer is going to do the job. Well, Timoteus is now on the way to Imperia. He's killing some villagers. He's there with the elite Magunas. He needs to go back. Combo, let's kill. Yeah. Cavaliers and elite Magunas. There you go. And Timoteus is on the way to Imperia. He has been really, really behind in these games. Well, if the colors is hard to see, what can I do? This is the colors they pick. Nothing I can do. Nothing else I can do. Now, I can put the microphone in the normal mode. No more whisper mode activated because my family, I can listen that they are all awake. And now, the games are close to be over. It's possible because even if Red is with a really strong population. You can see how he's coming with elite Magunais and Cavaliers. Slam is starting the caravan. He's doing the, yeah, go, go, go. Oh, be careful, man, be careful. Now he's pushing more. Well, Magunais is getting inside. If he's getting inside, he can do the disaster on the Fëanor. Definitely, man, definitely. Look at those Cav Archers. Well, now I'm feeling better. I'm awake for already like how much? Almost 2 hours. So there you go. Paladins! Paladins there, man! Paladins there! Paladins there for Barry! Well, Melkor 200 population. Timoteus, Castle Age. With 98 villages, he's doing a castle. Then he has another. Well, he has 2 castles. Gonna make the third. But this is a problem. Thank you for the Lutis. Lutis is the way to go. Support for free. If you don't support with that, then when are you going to support? The Lutis is the way to go. Yes, Slam Mongol. He has a lot of Kavars, but this is Paladin. They will call the GG soon, man, because this is a total domination. Yes, Slam is also recovering now. Look at the score. It's even better almost than Melkor. This is impossible, man. Really, really impossible now for the brothers to come back in this game. He's doing elite Magunais, yes, but it's gonna be an oath. It's gonna be an oath or not. It's a way to support the stream, the channel, and you don't have to spend anything. Just leave a message, like if you are leaving a message from on Twitter. Just click it, read it, easy, register, and you leave a message. Like, hey man, thank you for casting. Something like that. And that will pop up that alert and support the stream. But here, look at the amount of paladins he has. It's crazy. And the amount of Magundais he has. Slam. While yellow, 7 army. 7 army. 7 army, man. The Timoteus 115, and those paladins and combo together with the Magunais. Oh my god. Well, he's still trying to keep calm with more and more Magunais. It's true that he's killing some Sling. Yeah, 1,000 gold is laying. There you go. Yeah, but... And they are not going into the trade because they don't have trade, but... If they go, imagine. The problem is, we have Cap Arches and Magundice against Magundice and Paladins. Who win? Pretty obvious, right? Pretty obvious. The combo is just way better, man. Way better. If you have both range units while the other is one range unit and Paladins, who's gonna win? Maybe? Not maybe, Mr. Matros. For sure, he should have gone Paladins. Definitely gone Paladins. But he went fast. And the fastest way to go is Cav Arches. Why? He was doing a lot of Cav Arches in Castellage. And the transition to Paladins, it was going to be slower. He wanted to attack fast and unpredictable. But now they have army. They have some good army there. Let's see if they are going to get together. All Cav Archers. All Cav Arches units. It's Kivi and Magundice. But since they don't have a lot of trade yet, yeah, they are doing some good job. It's fully upgrade Magundice for Fëanor, but you need to go back because he's coming. He's coming with more. Ay, ay, ay. The drill from Slam. Slam is going to destroy. When he's getting inside with those siege rams and Magundice, Melkor will call the GG because he's gonna notice that Slam is in total domination beast mode. Siege ram with Ferrari's upgrade and killing absolutely everything. Gonna kill the castle, and when he's killing the castle, he has nothing there to defend. Well, he's sending heavy Cav Arches, but then how to stop this? Whoa, good amount of Magundice finally. Okay. Nah, it's impossible. This is just impossible, man. I don't know why Coven and Emin, they won the previous round, yes, and they just give up. I don't know why to join a tournament like this. It's pretty sad and disappointed because, yeah, I would love to see Coven and Emin playing. Not disrespect for the brothers, but, well, they won it, and Coven, I want to see a legend like Coven play. Hello, Mothub! You see, like I told you last night when I went to sleep, I was going to wake up, and you came later than me, same on you, Mothum. But here he keep coming. Well, 190 population, 140, he's doing another castle and another one. The push is absolutely real, he has some Magundice, he's getting destroyed. Oh my god, and they are calling the GG. This was a fast series because they had more, well, they are stronger player, yeah, that's it. And tower up, yeah, this is what the Slam did. Can get Magundite earlier. Achievements. Military. 77 largest army. At the end, Slam got the most unit kills with crazy amount of army. But Timotheus was a bit behind in those games. And Melkor did a good job as well. Barry. But it was basically 2 versus 1 at some point. He was slinging a bit, and for that he was able to do the elite Magundice. This is, guys, the 3-0 for the Tyrants with, to be honest, a total domination in this series. Guys, that was the games from Masters of Arabia today.